You don't even know what I'm trying to say.
Go on, man.
Yes.
Like, so he rose with Jesus, obviously, yeah?
Huh?
He rose with Jesus, obviously. He's 11 years old.
Yes,
over
yes.
Over time, people have redone it, and they've narrated comments.
Yes.
So that might be one of their narrations. I don't know if Ibn Kathir actually said it himself, because different people have done the book themselves. And, like, the same way he wrote it, that's probably not the same like version. It might have the same hadith for the same ayahs and the same reason.
It's not hadith.
But,
it's not
exactly,
hadith.
That's
maybe
hadith.
Hadith.
Isn't
that what it is?
I know that's what
I'm talking about. The Shiva, verse 86.
Yeah.
Interpretation.
I know it's not.
But Quran, you cannot do the Fiqh Quran. You have to be Alim. You have to be a scholar. You can't.
But the way I
no, I'm going to Ibn Kathir. I'm not going to do something else.
I'm not saying Ibn Kathir didn't say that. And if he did say it, I still want to hadith anyway. But I'm just saying. But people, they've redone the book, innit? Because I've read it, even for Bukhari, for example, yeah? There's different versions of Bukhari, innit? Like, if you read it, like, different versions. When I say different versions, I mean like a new, like, something that was just printed like in 2000, for example. And they've got their own version. The hadith got the same order. It's true. I know it's true, bruv. We mean no, bruv. I know it's true. Because I know that, innit?
Hadith is holy.
Yeah, I know, but I'm saying different people have redone the book, bruv.
I'm saying in Arabic, it's also called Isnad, which is a chain of narration.
Not about the hadith itself.
No, listen.
I'm talking about the person that redone the book. Not about the hadith and the Isnad.
You have called chain of narration called Isnad. So when we know the person is reliable, for example, like Abu Huraira, Allah Ta'ala heard that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, those who are authentic. So it's not something that's saying.
That's
like,
what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about the actual hadith itself. I'm talking about the person that reprinted the book. Obviously, the version that he wrote, someone else, like say you're a scholar and you understand the hadith or whatever, you might redo his book. You understand? I'm not talking about redo the hadith itself. The hadith might have the same Islam. I'm not talking about that part. I'm talking about the book itself. So the order of the hadith, like for instance, the book of marriage might be in a different place or whatever. It's a different person. Someone else did it, innit? And they might have their own narration, innit? You understand? They might add, yeah, this is what he meant or whatever. They might say these things. He might not have said those words. He might have said the hadith, but yeah, this is the generation. But those, because they've redone the book, innit? There's different versions of the same book.
We have a lot of kutubs, like volumes of books.
Yeah.
Volume of books, if basically like Baghdad al-Mahmal, Kitab al-Sitta.
What's that?
Ulum Hadith. These are kutubs, books.
Books? Oh yeah, books.
Yeah. I'm just breaking it down.
No, I just mean from one book.
Bukhari, Muslim,
over years, people.
Sahih Muslim, Al-Nisa'i, Al-Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Al-Nisa'i, all the volumes, all. Everything that we have, we don't take from weak, puny sources. We take authentic, sahih
even sources. Even these things, yeah? I'll give you a different example. Forget like the verse I'm talking about here, yeah? Like marriage, for example. Like you lot will say, for example, you need to have a wali and two witnesses in it if you get married, right? Well, I don't know what you say, but people say that, innit? You need a wali and two witnesses.
That's what I'm trying to get you at, bro.
Because I've read the whole Quran. It don't tell you nothing about one and two witnesses. Well, if you've got a question for a loan, for example, it'll tell you, yeah, you need two witnesses for a loan, then. But for one and stuff, don't tell you. But this is my point. There's hadith saying, yeah, you need one and two witnesses, right? I've seen that, yeah? So, okay. But in, I don't know, one of the four methods, yeah? Hanafi, Shafi, Hanbali, or one of them anyway. Because I remember I was looking for this stuff on purpose, yeah? One of them's got a hadith saying you don't need a one and two witnesses. Do you understand? But to these people, they're one of the four schools of thought, and they're all trustworthy. But they probably never trust this guy. Well, I can't say don't trust the guy, but they're not following that. And in the Quran itself, we don't even say you need that, innit? So how are you going to prove it? Personally, that's just an example I'm talking about. And even Mutta. Majahid, he's a very... Exactly.
He's a Shia, man.
Exactly. This is what I'm saying. Is it from? That guy had Ibn Kathir, yeah? Now listen, in Ibn Kathir, Majahid, he's one of the most trustworthy hadith raised. He learned from Abdul Ibn Abbas. He's one of his students. He tells you, Surah Nisa, verse 24, the last part of I told you about Islam. Mujahid.
Yeah.
Mujahid.
Yeah.
You know Mujahid? You heard of him?
Yeah, of course.
Exactly, him. He's one of the narrators in Ibn Kathir, bro. Yeah? Verse, Surah Nisa, verse 24, where it tells you, Islam, the word, only word I remember the hadith in the ayah for right now is Islam Tatum. That's a version of the word mutter, innit? That means mutter basically. Yeah? In the translation you read, it might just say, yeah, for benefit. They use it that way, innit? But he's telling you this word, this part, this ayah was revealed especially for mutter and it was not never abrogated. That's what he said. Jazan.
He's
not a Shia, bruv. I had the Sahih Muslim in my house, man. Bruv, Sahih Muslim, it's in Sahih Muslim.
We don't believe in mutter.
Bruv, it's in Ibn Kathir, bruv. You just told me you believe the guy, innit? I know you don't. I know you don't, bro.
You know what it means?
I know what it means.
He's a Shia.
I know what it means. I know what Shia says.
Trade your mother, to go have relations.
Huh?
Trade your mother to have like sexual
relations. That's what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about that, innit? I've seen hadiths where people did go to in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, innit? So obviously they're not doing that, innit? You understand? Like Abu Bakr's daughter had a child from Mutter. And things like that. There's better hadiths around, innit? You understand? People did bad shit, but I'm saying, yeah, him personally, and I've seen hadith in Sahih Muslim or whatever, Abdullah ibn Abbas or Bukhari, so Abdullah ibn Abbas telling you, you can do it. There's more than one hadith, yeah, he's telling you, he did it from his president, he never forbid it, yeah. One, there's another one when he's going blind, when he's getting old. So this is obviously after Ali's dead, because there's hadith when they say Ali told him, yeah, that it's been abrogated and he accepted. But anyway, this is obviously when Ali's dead because he's old. Muhammad said, yeah, if you don't say, stop saying you can do it, we're going to stone you. There's a hadith, it's in Sahih Muslim, it's in one you're Sahih Yain, bro. Sahih Muslim Bukhari is your Sahih Yain. This is what I'm saying.
Brother Himadi, we're going on too much topics now.
I'm just giving you different examples about the same thing, bro.
Okay, I'll just say what I'm saying, let's not try and get confused. So the main thing at the end of the day we need to try and concentrate is just Tawheed, the oneness of Allah. And that's the main purpose here. That's the main purpose. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us with a unique purpose. This is the Surah to Zariyah, I didn't make the jinn kind nor the man kind, but that they worship me. So this is the essence of why we are here, to worship our creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The creator, and that Islam is the only deen, the only way of life that Allah is going to accept. Because inna deena inna Allah alayhi Islam, Surah Ali Imran chapter 3, ayah 18. The only way of life that the only way Allah to you is Islam. The only way. What is Islam? Islam is submission to rule to God, as all the other prophets, the messengers, Musa, Isa, Ayub, Ibrahim, Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, Asbab, Bani Israel, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They've all been nahna Muslimun. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last and final messenger Allah sent for the whole of humanity. And that's what we should concentrate on. This is the message of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu
alayhi wa sallam. That's what I'm trying to say, bro. And these people differ on it,
when he said, Mu'adh bin Jabal to Yemen, he said, you're going to the people of the book. The first thing you should call to is Tawheed.
Yeah.
So the first thing is, as I'm here today, I'm here to call you to Tawheed, to call you to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the first important thing. That's the first important thing. If you're going to matters like this, I'm not going to
trust these guys personally,
okay.
Because they ain't got a clear mind frame on the subject. You know what I'm saying? Because in their own books, that's what I'm telling you. I'm not talking about Shia books. I won't give a comment to you Shia books. You don't believe in that, bro. I'm just talking about your own.
It's Bartu,
not your,
it's false, anyway. Huh? It's false in Bartu anyway.
That's what I'm trying to say, bro. Omar forbade it, blood. So Abu Bakr, they're still doing it. Then someone got caught, or someone got caught, but someone had got pregnant. Something happened anyway, and he said, I'm going to forbid this. It's in Bukhari and Muslim as well. The books that they say is Sahihain, bro. It's not even like it's in another book or whatever. It's in the books they say are the two strongest books, bro, because of the way they do the Isnad as you say, bro. That's what they say, bro. It's in those books. I remember there's a time when I was reading stuff, bro. You understand?
You need to understand the main thing, yeah?
Yeah.
They have something called ulama of muhaddith. We have the scholars of hadith.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The science of al-hadith.
Yeah.
The science of al-hadith. Mm. So I'm not going to say on this matter. I know some of it, but I'm not going to say. But I would say, if go refer to the scholars, the ulama.
Yeah.
Secondly, if you have to find mankind has to find the purpose of life is to worship the Creator, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We call people to Tawheed, to Islam, to find about the misconceptions of Islam, for example, to know about the Quran. It's the final speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not been changed, it's not been corrupted, it's still the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we find anything, any of those books, this is what we're calling people to. We're calling people to work wonders of Allah, and that into the final message. So I hope that Allah guides you sincerely, and that you get one day use of Islam, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, 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 Alhamdulillah. So, okay, inshallah.